Anyone who lives in a major city knows that traffic is one of those niggling, persistent annoyances, and a new study has identified a potential cause. You're not keeping the right distance from the car behind you, which sounds like it can't be your problem since you can't control the guy that's staying uncomfortably close to your bumper. True, but mathematical models show that if every car on the road kept the same distance between the car in front of and behind it, traffic would move seamlessly and potentially even twice as fast. But of course, it's not that simple. Traffic is a great example of emergent property, a philosophical term used to describe the phenomenon of many small things compiling to create something bigger. With traffic, it's the many individual cars together forming a complex traffic mess. That's because humans bring a lot of variables to the mix. A driver is usually, and rightly, most focused on the car she's following. But if she brakes hard, the car behind her will have to brake a little harder. If she gets close to another car, the density in that one area will cause a slowdown. Mathematical models have shown that basically at a certain density, there are enough variables brought by human reaction time and individual driving habits to cause a traffic jam. We have a little more on that right up here. Interestingly, this is a human problem. Ants don't experience traffic jams. They move as quickly in small groups as they do en masse. Bats are the same. They fly in large groups, each one tracking the bats around him with echolocation. They play follow the leader, even if that leader is in the back of the pack, in an impressive display of group coordination. But we're not a colony, we're individuals. Yeah, except that self-driving cars could bring this colony-like behavior to humans. A simple solution the new research offers is sensors to improve bilateral control in cars. Current adaptive cruise control monitors the car ahead of you, providing it's not miles down the freeway. A similar rear-facing sensor would be an easy change to that same system. Looking back is really no harder than looking forward, and we wouldn't even need to change the roads. The result would be well worth it. Not only would we reduce the stress of rush hour driving, minimizing start-stop traffic would cut CO2 emissions and help you save fuel. And it would also make driving safer. It could really be a win-win-win all around. For more insight into the science all around you, be sure to subscribe. And speaking of weird traffic patterns, is anything truly random? Jules dove into that one right here. And fun driving fact, driving while blindfolded is, weirdly, explicitly illegal in the state of Alabama.